Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner, brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. Now, there are probably some of you who haven't yet sent in for one of those handy little pocket-sized flashlights that Lum and Abner are sending out. You'd better do that right away, folks. You certainly don't want to pass up this opportunity to get a fine, useful flashlight with the compliments of your old friends, Lum and Abner. All you have to do, you know, to get one of these flashlights, complete with bulb and battery, is to send in the wrapper from a package of Horlicks malted milk powder. Maybe from any size package, either natural or chocolate flavor, but it must be from a package of Horlicks malted milk powder. I mean by that that wrappers from Horlicks tablets are not eligible. Write your name and address on the back of the wrapper and then send it, enclosing 10 cents, which is only to cover the cost of packing and mailing, to Lum and Abner, care of the station to which you are listening. You got that? All right. Now, in return, Lum and Abner will send you this handsome aluminum fountain pen-sized flashlight, complete with bulb and battery. Now, there's nothing difficult about that, is there? Do you know of any easier way to get a powerful, efficient flashlight? The kind that you'd have to pay 75 cents for in a store. Well, send in your request right away, tonight, before you forget it. If you haven't a package of Horlicks malted milk powder in your home now, you can get it in either natural or chocolate flavor at your druggist. And now, let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. When Lum and Abner planned for Lum to slip over to Abner's house the other night and retrieve that check the insurance company paid on the claim on Abner's fake accident, little did they realize the trouble it would cause. The citizens of Pine Ridge felt that if they could find the culprit who broke into Abner's house, they would clear up several mysterious robberies that had been committed recently. Well, yesterday, they found clues that definitely identified Lum with the crime. And the old fellow has been arrested, locked up in jail. As we look in on our old friends today, we find Abner at the jail door. Listen.
Lum! Hey, Lum! Lum! Hey, Lum!
Who is
Lum.
It? Who is it?
Hey, it's me, Abner. Are you asleep?
No, I'm just sitting here studying.
Well, I just come over to tell you how sorrowful I am about this whole thing, Lum.
Oh, that's all right, Abner. I ain't blaming you none over it.
I never hated to do anything so bad in my life, but there just weren't no way out of it.
Why, of course not. You're the constable here, and you can't let friendship keep you from tending to the duties of your office.
I just hate to see you locked up in jail this way when I know you ain't guilty, Lum.
Well, I'll be out of here before long. Grandpappy Spears is out raising bond for me to bail me out.
He is.
Now, come on in. Sit down a while. Nice and warm in here.
Yeah, oh, well, you'll have to reach through the bars here, Lum, and get my keys and unlock the door. I can't do a thing with these arms bandaged up this way.
Yeah, here. That's him?
Yeah, that's him right there. Just unlock the door now, Lum, and shove it back open that way for me.
I'd have noticed that easy. I'd have slipped out of here.
Yeah, well,
come on in.
Got out, got the keys.
No, that's right.
Oh.
Well, here, better take them keys back. I don't want nobody to find them in my pocket.
Oh, well, you ain't gonna run off.
Hey, come on back and sit here by the stove.
Yeah.
Is that a flopper?
Yeah, that's all right.
As big as a bucket,
isn't it? Yeah, that's a good thing you got it. These concrete floors are awful damp in this time of year.
Well, Abner, I'm proud you come over. Been shorter in the door. Mm-hmm. About the only one left around here that'll even speak to me. You and Grandpap.
Yeah, folks is pretty mad about it, all right. They think you're the one that's been doing all this robbing around here lately, you know.
Yeah, I know it. There's been a dozen of them come by here, stand there at the door and call me a thief and robber and everything else. Here. Sit down.
Yeah, thank you.
Folks all I thought was my friends and just turned right square backwards again me.
Yeah, Law, they're the ones that insisted on me throwing you in jail. Six fellas at Ezra Seastrunk and Caleb Weasant Mole's Moots and a whole bunch.
Yeah, that hurts me worse than anything else.
Why, sure.
Even Dick Huddleston come by this morning and told me how disappointed he was in me. So I know he must think I'm guilty, too.
Yeah, well, naturally, they had the proof right on you, Lum. They found that piece of cloth hanging on the barbed wire fence over there, and it matched up with that place that was tore out of your pants, so There weren't no doubt in their minds but what you done it.
Now, it just goes to show that folks is all as ready and willing to believe the worst about anybody.
Yeah.
Even their best friends.
Yeah, they are.
Just human nature, I reckon. When a feller gets down this way, instead of trying to help him up, why, everybody wants to shove him just a little further down if they can.
Well, I wish you'd let me just go ahead and tell Elizabeth and everybody else how this whole thing happened.
No, Abner. That's nice of you to offer to do that, but I just won't stand for it.
Well, it'd straighten this whole thing out, Lum. Get you out of this mess.
Get me out of trouble, all right, but I'm just afraid it'd cause a lot of trouble twixt you and Elizabeth. If she found out now there weren't nothing to that accident, you just been making out like you'd hurt, no telling what she would do.
No.
Might break up your home over there. You can't never tell.
Yeah, but maybe we could just tell her, Lum, that the reason that you broke into the house the other night was just to get that check that the insurance company gave me before she could cash it.
Well, the trouble is, Abner, you can't tell her part of it without telling her the whole story.
No.
If you just stop and think back, we've told so many stories to Elizabeth, she'd lose all the faith she ever had in you if she found out the truth now.
Yeah. I don't know what to do. I hate to see you sitting down here in jail, having everybody down on you over something that ain't your fault. Special when you just done it to help me out. I just don't feel right about it.
Oh, well, now, don't worry about me.
I just feel like I'm the one that ought to be in jail, Steve.
No, now, there ain't no use of standing chances of breaking up your home over there. Don't matter none about me. I ain't got no family that this will reflect on. Nobody that cares for it, that goes. I'll be out of here quick as Grandpap gets back with that barn anyway.
Well, you just got to get out, Lum. The mail is stacking up down there at the office. I never seen the like of it.
Well, fine. There's still riding in for the flashlight.
Oh, Lord,
ain't asked
morning,
about
yeah.
that. Well, that's good. Enough of our friend sends in for them flashlights, we can at least get the store restocked and opened up again. Give us a sort of a chance to start all over again.
Well, I've had Cedric down there helping me all day, opening up letters for me while I count the votes and see which one of us they want for president or to jot them down at door when we get it opened up.
How's the votes running?
Well, I don't like to tell you nothing that'll make you feel any worse, Lum. It just looks like you've had enough trouble.
Well, it ain't your fault, Abner. If folks want you to be president, you can't help it. Ain't I running no better than I have been?
Well, we ain't got all the mail open up yet, Lum. We ain't went through more than half of it, what's come in today.
Well, how many have I got so far?
You mean out of them we got today?
Yeah, how many votes have I got?
Well, you ain't got none yet, Lum. It's all been for me, but now I wouldn't feel bad about it now, for maybe you've got some votes in them that we ain't opened up yet.
No, I don't reckon I have, Abner. I can see already that I ain't as popular as I thought I was.
Well, of course, I want to get all the votes I can, Lum, but I don't want you to feel hard at me.
Why, no, of course not, Abner. I ain't blaming nobody but myself. That letter we got the other day where that woman from Lincoln, Nebraska had wrote in and said I was a big blowhard and all has run over you and she hoped I never got a single vote.
Yeah, well, now, I wouldn't pay no attention to such talk as that.
Well, I don't know, Abner. It got me to studying. I've had a lot of time last night and all morning. I think she's about right about it.
Oh, no.
I ain't been as thoughty as I ought to been.
Why, he has.
Had way on her too good old opinion myself, I reckon. Thought the minute we started that contest, everybody would write in and say they want me for president. But see now about where I stand, I reckon.
And I don't feel bad.
Sort of hard on a feller after being president or something for so long and then have to step down now. It ain't like if I weren't used to holding high offices that way.
No.
I've always took such a pride in all the offices I have.
Why, natural.
Justice of the peace and president of the school board. I've held that office for years.
Oh, yeah, Lord. You've been president of the school board ever since I can recollect.
Well, good people of this district honored me with that office, and I've tried my best to make them a good president.
You did it.
I look back and see some of the scholars that went through our little school over there and went out and made successes of themselves. I have to feel a little proud of myself, knowing that I had a hand in their education.
Why, sure, you ought to.
Well, it gives me a chance to see that these children around here get the advantages that I never had when I was a young and growing up.
Why, sure.
Proud to do it.
Yeah, sure. I believe that, that's Grandpap coming yonder, Lum. I reckon he's got your bond.
Well, fine. Yeah, I'm glad you're here so she can let me out.
Yeah, as soon as he hands me that bond, why, there ain't no reason why I can't turn you loose, then.
I'll be glad to get out of here. Let me get my hat and coat on so it won't lose no time.
Yeah, get all ready, sure.
There's that quilt you brung down here for me. You better take that back over to your place.
Yeah, well, I had to slip that out of the house. Elizabeth never knowed I brung it over. Just come on in, Grandpa. The door's unlocked there.
Oh, why not?
Spirit, I've got some bad news for you, Lum. Bad news?
What's the matter?
Couldn't you get the bond, Grandpap?
Lum, I tried everybody in this town. I couldn't get a soul to sign this bond for you.
Oh, handsome.
Well.
And it looks like everybody turned again you. They said you could stay in this jail for the rest of your life for as they cared.
Well, thank you anyway, Grandpap. I know you done your best.
Now, there was some that I never seen. They was having a sort of a meeting there in the lodge hall, sort of a mass meeting. There's one or two in there that I never got a chance to talk to.
Yeah, I heard they're having that.
Well, just let it go, Grandpap. Maybe we can study up something else or some other way. Thank you. I did want to get out, for, you know, me and Abner's got this contest on. Most folks won't want to vote for me for president, and me laying down here in jail this way.
I don't think that'll make no difference, Lum.
Well, I can't get out to drum up no votes or nothing, though.
Yeah, well, Lum, you was getting beat anyway. You know that. You ain't got but two votes out of all the letters we've got so far.
Well, I'll be dead blamed.
Huh?
What you reckon them fellas is wanting?
Well, Squire Skimp and Ezra Seastrong.
Yeah, Squire was the one that called that meeting this afternoon.
He was.
Well, good evening, gentlemen. Good evening.
Well, howdy,
fellas.
Come on in, Squire. The door ain't locked.
Yeah, come in.
Don't know. I reckon we're a little more particular who we associate with than Abner and Grandpapper is. He, Edry. No, I can tell you what I want from right here. The good people of Pine Ridge had a meeting this afternoon, Lum, and me and Ezra was appointed to come over here and tell you that we don't feel that a thief and a robber is a fitting kind of a man to have at the head of our school. And we're asking you for your resignation as president of the board of directors.
Hmm. Well, with Lum's friends all deserting him, it looks like Abner will have very little trouble winning the contest and becoming president of the Jot 'em Down store. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to remind you once more to be sure and send in right away for one of these fine little pocket-sized flashlights that Lum and Abner are giving away. That's easy to do, you know. You simply send in the wrapper from a package of Horlick's malted milk powder. Wrapper from any size, even natural or chocolate flavor package. Make sure, though, that it's from Horlick's malted milk powder. Wrappers from Horlick's tablets, I mean, are not eligible. Now write your name and address on the back of the wrapper and enclose 10 cents to cover the cost of packing and mailing your flashlight. Then mail your wrapper and dime to Lum and Abner, care of the station to which you are listening. In return, Lum and Abner will send you this powerful, useful little pocket-sized flashlight, complete with bulb and battery. But don't forget, folks, to send in for your flashlight right away. Do it tonight. Lum and Abner want everybody to send in for a flashlight. The old fellows are making this offer to see how many of you there are who enjoy their program and enjoy Horlick's malted milk, too. This is Carlton Bricker, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlick's, who now bid you all good night and good health.